Hello friends, we have seen what is forecasting, what are the methods of forecasting, what is the statistical method, simple regression we have studied in the last session. After the forecasting methods, we will be studying what are the various forecasting errors. At the end of the session, you will be able to investigate what are the forecasting errors and you will be able to calculate various forecasting errors with the given formula. We will have first introduction of errors, then we will be studying what are the various types of forecasting errors, mainly bias, mean absolute deviation, mean absolute percentage error, mean square error, tracking signals. Okay. Forecasting errors. What is a forecasting error? We try to forecast with variety of methods, maybe Delphi technique or maybe statistical technique, even maybe using some of the latest softwares also. We try to find out from the past data what will be the projected figure for the future data. And once actual data will come into the reality, we try to compare the forecasted value versus actual value. And we will be seeing that there will be some difference between the forecasted and the actual data. The difference is known as error. The difference can be on the positive side or the difference can be on the negative side. Both errors are not a welcome situation from the organization point of view. Suppose if the actual data tells you that the sales demand has increased than the forecasting figure, then probably we will be having a shortage in the market of our products and then probably that may be taken by some other customer. That is not advisable. In the second case, if the actual data falls short of the forecasted value, that means we are selling less than the forecasted. As a result of that, we have invested into resources, we have built up the inventory, and as a result of that, we are unable to sell. That will result into the inventory pileup. Maybe in some cases, it may lead to stocks, which will have inventory is sometimes maybe a dangerous situation. It may block cash flow, it may block capacity. And sometimes if the product is not continued in the next quarter or the next period, there are chances of obsolescence and damage to the product. So in that case, that also is not a welcome situation. The basic purpose is we try to minimize the gap between the actual and the forecasted values. So the difference between the forecasted and actual value is generally called as the error. The ultimate aim of all calculations, all methodologies, all approaches is try to build that error should be as minimum as possible. As you know, the forecast error is the difference between the actual and the forecasted value for the corresponding period. In terms of a equation, it can be written as ET is equal to YT minus FT, where E is the forecasting error at period T, Y is the actual value at period T, and F is the forecast for the period T. There are number of methods. Forecasting error can be calendar forecast error or cross-sectional forecast error when we want to summarize the forecast error over a group of units. Now, forecasting is a very funny data interpretation. As the forecasting period is longer, the data, the error will be more. As the forecasting period will be shorter, there will be a small error. It also depends upon all geographical factors, the calendar months, the areas and the units and the product mix and so on and so forth. So forecasting error, we can summarize it as per our requirement for which we want to take the data analysis and take further decisions on the data. If you observe that average forecast error for the time series of the forecast for the same product or phenomena, that we call this as a calendar forecast error or time series forecast error. What is the meaning of this? Suppose if we take Diwali season or any festival season for this particular year, take the similar sale and similar forecast value of the corresponding earlier years, then we take this as a calendar forecast error. What was the error? What was the actual sales data in the last festival, last to last festival? And based on that, we will be able to calculate any forecasting this time. Then that error, what was the error in the earlier period? That error was called as calendar forecast error. If you observe this for multiple products and for the same period, then this is called as cross-sectional performance error. If you take the data for multiple products, then it becomes cross-sectional performance error. Now, what are the various types of forecasting errors? We will study one by one. The first and very simple preliminary error is called as generally bias. bias indicates the directional tendency of the forecasting error. If the forecasting repeatedly overestimates actual demand, bias will have a positive value and underestimation will be indicated by the negative value. Bias is equal to sum of the forecasting period errors for all periods divided by number of periods. That is forecasted demand minus actual demand upon n. But to think now, what is the meaning of bias is positive or zero, or bias can be negative also. Look at the definition and then try to find out answer for this simple question. Right? Positive bias means forecasted value is more than the actual demand. It means that we have forecasted to a higher extent and the actual demand is less. We are unable to sell as per the forecast. As a result of that, we may come to the conclusion that our products are having inventories. Ideally, the bias should be zero, that is actual demand and forecasted value should be similar. If the bias value is negative, in that case forecasted value is less than the actual demand. It means we will be having shortage of our products in the market. As a result of that, there are chances that we may lose our market to our competitors. So on the one side, positive bias will indicate more inventory. On the negative side, it will indicate shortages. What is indication of all these biases? Bias is called as directional error. If continuously for some period of time, the bias shows to be positive trend, or for a continuous trend, the bias shows negative value, then it is a matter of concern that we have to review and rethink how the method of calculating or forecasting, and then probably it needs some correction. Natural tendency of plus minus is obvious. Statistical variations in the demand are obvious. If plus minus is there, we can correlate to the actual market demand and then market variations. But continuity in the same positive or negative direction definitely calls for review in the forecasting method itself. Right? Now, the second error is the mean absolute deviation, which indicates on an average basis how many units the forecast is off from the actual data. It is not taking the signatures, or it is not taking positive or negative value, it is taking absolute value. That is why it is called as mean absolute deviation. It is related as sigma into ET upon N, where sigma T is absolute value of the error and the number of period of evaluation. It generally tells what is the total absolute deviation. It may be from the positive side or negative side. Further to it, we can calculate mean absolute percentage error, which indicates on an average how much percentage of the forecast is off from the actual data. Since bias is directly giving in terms of the quantities, whereas mean absolute percentage error, we'll try to estimate error in terms of percentage. What is the percentage is sigma ET divided by AT divided by N into 100, whereas sigma ET is the absolute value of the error, N is the number of periods of evaluation, and AT is the actual demand for the period T. This will tell you the percentage error is 20%, 30%, 40%, whatever the percentage may be. The percentage will tell us how much we are deviating from our values. Percentage is not considering any negative or positive sign. It may not indicate directional values as such. Third type of error generally which is calculated in the forecasting method is called as mean square error, generally called as MSE. A forecast error measures that penalizes large error proportionately more than the small errors. It is a method that we are trying to find out. In a way, we are giving some consideration for the large and small error proportionality. Large error is having more penalty as compared to smaller error. It will generally a good indicator so as to take some corrective action on the forecasting method or on the further decisions based on the forecasting method. It is generally represented as sigma ET square divided by N, where ET is the value of error. We are taking the square of the value of error and then we are dividing it by N is equal to number of periods. Tracking signal the ratio of cumulative forecasting errors to the corresponding value of the MAD. It monitors any forecast that have been made in comparison with the actual and ones when there are unexpected departures of the outcome from the forecast. So tracking signal is actual value minus forecasted value divided by mean absolute deviation. So it tries to give a signal and whether you are on the track or right. So depending upon the purpose, we can use the method of calculating the error. A proper method is used, and then the ultimate purpose should be the error should be as minimum as possible. Now here is a small example where we have given some sales data and forecasted data, and you have to calculate the various forecast errors. The answer is given over here. Bias is minus 2, absolute mean absolute deviation is 58, MSE is 8280, and then MAP is 2.64. Similarly, we can calculate the errors into the given data. We can have alternative examples also based on this. So this data will be useful for the interpretation of errors and taking right corrective actions. Thank you.